She may be one of the world's greatest tennis players, but Serena Williams says that she still faced frightening complications, and it was after the birth of her daughter.
Yeah, this is terrifying stuff, and Williams is not alone. What she experienced is something a lot of other women have faced. And as Adrian Broaddus reports, it happens most often to Black mothers.
On the tennis court, Serena Williams dominates. Some matches more challenging than others, but life served its greatest challenge for Serena after her daughter was born.
How you doing, Olympia?
In Vogue magazine, Williams first shared her medical nightmare. She says holding her baby for the first time was an amazing feeling. A day later, Serena said everything went bad. The tennis star had trouble breathing and told the staff it was a sign of blood clots. She had the symptoms before, but initially a nurse brushed her off. Serena persisted and told doctors the treatment she needed.
Her story is an important one, but it's one in millions of stories, sadly.
Dr. Rachel Hardiman is an assistant professor at the University of Minnesota School of Public Health.
The disparities we see in birth outcomes, experiences like Serena's that we see are happen regardless of socioeconomic status. So it doesn't matter if you are a Black woman who is highly accomplished and like Serena and well known.
All the money in the world.
Exactly, all the money in the world. Or even someone like me who has a PhD and is married to a physician, the research shows that's irrelevant. That doesn't matter.
Hardiman is leading a project exploring ways to reduce racial inequities in birth outcomes. According to the CDC, 50,000 women experience complications during pregnancy every year. About 700 women die, and Black women are 3 to 4 times more likely than white women, in part due to higher risk factors.
To put the kind of the disparities in perspective, Black women are 21% more likely to die from heart-related disease or heart-related illness, and they're 71% more likely to die from cervical cancer, but 243% more likely to die due to complications of childbirth.
What's the solution?
A multitude of solutions. There's not just one magic bullet. To think about the role that implicit racial bias or automatic bias plays, or unconscious bias plays, in how they're delivering care. Those are huge things that can go a long ways towards improving the quality of care for everyone.
What do you say to the white male listening to this story who's talking to the TV saying it's not just Black women, it's white women too?
The statistics don't lie. They tell an important story, and it's one that we can't ignore right now.
On Tuesday, Williams posted on her Facebook page saying in part, "I hope my story can inspire a conversation that gets us to close this gap."
If we're not working to close that gap, the racial gap, we're not going to get very far in improving the health and well-being for anyone in our society.
Adrian brings up, I think, one of the most important points I've heard in a long time on this show, talking about implicit bias. If you don't like what you're hearing in that story and just claim it's not true, you're the problem.
I didn't know those facts. Mm-hmm. I didn't know those statistics existed. So that was fascinating for me to understand. And no mother and no family wants any complications. And it also talks about just general communication between physician and patient. Even someone with Serena Williams' status can be overlooked and misheard and not listened to and believed.
But it's more so because she's a Black woman.
Perhaps, yes.
Well, that's what the data shows.
Perhaps, perhaps. But it's just fascinating. Thank you, Adrian.
Best of luck to Serena. We'll be right back.